This is a game that is a bit hard to describe. I had not heard of Nier Automata before people started asking about it. I booted the game for a short test, and 8 hours later, I am realizing this is something I'm going to put more hours into. So, if you're into hack and slash games, although 8 hours in, I am not sure if this is just a hack and slash game anymore, you might want to give it a go. And that is when you discover, like I did, that this game is a GPU-hungry beast that causes problems on even newer GPUs. Not to worry, because there are tools that you can use to tweak some small aspects of the game that, on the right GPU, can make a huge difference. Welcome to the Low Spec Gamer, the show where we explore ways to get more performance from modern games on old or low-end GPUs. Let's go! Nier Automata... wait?
Nier Automata.
Alright. Nier Automata is a recently released game running on the Platinum engine, the same engine used on most games developed by Platinum. Also, it's one of those engines that have no user-readable configuration files. Why? Well, in the CPU department, I saw the game doing the same with an i5-750 or an Intel Celeron G1840. The real bottleneck is the GPU, with the game requiring a GTX 770. So, after setting the in-game settings to the lowest they go, I tested. First, on my personal favorite, the 2012 GT640 budget GPU, which gave me less than 25 FPS in any sort of fight, and this is on 800x600 resolution. Next, I tested with the GTX 460, which was considered a mid-end card when it released in 2010. This did quite a bit better, once again close to 25, sometimes 30, but this time on 720. Cool. What else can we do? The first thing that I have to quickly mention is that you can add a custom resolution on your GPU's control panel, especially a really low one, and it will show up in the game's menu. This is a good way to force the game to a very low 16:9 resolution if you need it. The main thing that I'm going to talk about, however, is this mod. Dr. Daxi discovered that this game utilizes a really performance-intensive global illumination method. And modder called Diane incorporated his code into a mod that fixes some resolution issues in the game to create this magnificent program, link in the description. And you will be surprised to see how much of a difference this can make. To install this mod, you simply run the installer and hit install, then hit yes when the files are installed, and then finish the installation. Then run the installer again and migrate the mod to the testing branch. When you open the game, you may get a dialog from the mod asking if you want to update. Make sure to hit yes and go through all the instructions so you have the latest version of the mod. Once installed, you can hit Ctrl+Shift+O to show some information regarding your computer, which is also a nice way of checking if the mod was correctly installed. And then you can press Ctrl+Shift+Backspace to open this menu. On the Nier Automata section, you can control the level of global illumination, going as far as disabling it. I did not notice any performance difference by changing the frame rate limiter or the bloom option. Disabling global illumination will cause some important visual differences on the shadows of the game, and some more dramatic ones on the illumination and coloring of some specific areas. But what is the trade-off in performance? On the 640, on a resolution of 768x432, I saw a generally more stable performance, but I am not sure that we'll call this game playable in this state. So, be wary if you're using a really low-end GPU. The 460 was an entirely different story. Unmodded, this test section was around 35 FPS just standing still, but after disabling global illumination, it climbs to almost 55 FPS. If you decide to jump into one of the game's creative boss battles, you will notice that when things get chaotic, it can still drop to the 30s, but it was never unplayable, which happened with the slightest hint of combat before. Regarding the game itself, it can get a bit interesting, so if you have the GPU for it, give it a try and let me know how it works for you. Thank you to the people in Patreon for making this kind of videos possible. See you on the next video.